Relationships, 5, financial security, health, opportunities, mental standing, another important things to maintain your addictive behaviors. Let me read that. Addiction is more important to me than any of these things in the world. Are you clinging to any beliefs that fear craving and aversion? Beliefs that deny the truth of impermanence are beliefs about how things in life should be, whether they. If you have experienced discrimination based on our social issues, how can you make the experience in a way that honors your true self without creating more pain and suffering? The third noble truth, ending the suffering. It is possible to end our suffering when you come to understand the nature of our craving and realize that all our experiences are temporal. Wearing by nature, we can begin a more skillful way to live with the distance. This faction that is part of being human. We learn the need to be torn apart by our thoughts and feelings that say, I have to have more of that, or all. Do anything to get rid of this. The third noble truth states that the end of craving is possible. Each of us has the capacity for recovery. We are responsible for our own reactions and for the energy we give our thoughts and feelings. This means we have some control over how we respond to our own suffering, because the unpleasant emotions take place within us. We create them through our response to experience. We don't need to depend on anyone or anything else to remove the causes of our suffering. We may not be able to control anything out there, but you can learn to choose what you think, say, and do. You come to hunger. Stand that if our thoughts, words, and actions are driven by greed, hatred, our conclusions, we are creating suffering within suffering. If we let go of these attitudes, we can lessen suffering and even create freedom. We can choose to give up these causes of disturbing and unpleasant emotions. This is the true empowerment and freedom of recovery, recognizing that happiness and suffering are left to us, based on how we choose to respond to our experiences. Inquiry of the third noble truth. What makes it so hard to quit? What resources are available to help you abstain and recover? Risk reasons to believe you can recover. Also risk your doubts. What? Make the wise and compassionate part of you. You're breathing off. Two ways. Say about these doubts. Practice letting go of something small. Notice what you're craving. Doesn't last and that there's a little sense of relief when you let it pass. That's a little taste of freedom. The fourth noble truth. The past. The Buddha taught that by living necessary, practicing metadata. Tune on, and developing wisdom and compassion, you can end the suffering. You create by resisting, running pain, and misunderstanding reality. The fourth noble truth is the path that summarizes central elements to recovery, or awakening, and leads to the ending of suffering. It provides an instructive practice for investigating the weakness. Being aware of the conditioned responses we cling to. These are the loop. facets of the past. 1. Rise understanding. 2. Rise intention. 3. Rise speech. 4. Rise action. 5. Rise livelihood. 6. Rise effort. 7. Rise mindfulness. 8. Rise concentration. These 8 factors can be divided into 3 groups. The wisdom group of understanding and intention. The ethics group of speech, action, and livelihood. The concentration group of effort, mindfulness, and concentration. Each of us will understand and practice each aspect of this. Eightfold path in our own way. We develop our wisdom, ethical practice, and concentration as far as we can in the beginning. As we come to a deeper understanding of the four noble truths we're able to bring. More effort and concentration to letting go of our greed, hatred, and conclusion. Our ethical development will cause us to reflect more deeply on these sources of our unwise actions. The Eightfold Path is a way of life that each of us follows in. Practices to the best of our current understanding and capacity. Your path can serve as both a religious and non-religious journey. For many people, their Buddhist practice includes prayer, worship, and ceremony. It is up to you to decide whether to include these practices as part of your recovery path. Inquiry is the fourth noble truth. Story. Understanding that recovery and an ending of suffering is possible. What is your path to recovery and ending the suffering of addiction? Be honest about the challenges you might face and the tools in.